What's up? I'm Amy, your resident Nini, and today I have a speed build, actually. And if I do say so myself, if I dare say so myself, one of the best interior designing choices I have made in pretty much ever. I'm not really much of a builder, but I've been working on the speed build for, God, a very long time. It's kind of like the same story with my Senua Sacrifice, Hellblade, whatever. It'll be in the title card above if you're interested. Video. Sorry, my thoughts all over the place today. I'm feeling good, so I decided I should do this voiceover, and yeah. But yeah, it's really cute. It's a quaint, like, kind of pastel-y little house. I forgot the size of the plot. I think it's a 20 by 15? I'm not sure. I don't think it's a 30 by 40. It's a Willow Creek. And Willow Creek is actually probably one of my favorite worlds just because of the beautiful lighting. Like, look how beautiful this looks. It's so cute. I wanted to challenge myself because I've never done a speed build. Okay, I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself. I've never done a speed build. I've never actually really built anything in The Sims for as long as I've played it. I'm really more of an interior designer. Actually, one of my friends is a really, really, really talented builder, like pretty much in every game he plays, like even on Minecraft, like anything he does is absolutely freaking gorgeous. And sometimes, not recently, but in the past, he's sent me some builds that he's done. And he's like, here, Amy, do the interior decorating. I was like, okay, hell yeah. And I did the interior decorating and we sent it like back and forth. Like he'd build houses, he'd send me the shell of the house and I'd do like the interior decorating and sent him pictures of what I'd done with the place. And it's one of my favorite things to do. But yeah, building, not so much my forte. But I went on Google and I looked at a couple of houses because I was like, you know what? I'm going to challenge myself. I'm going to try building, and I found some cute kind of like suburban American houses, and this one kind of stuck out to me because it was a little simple and not super really extravagant, you know, considering that I'm kind of a beginner in building. So yeah, I tried my hand at it and I actually really freaking loved how it turned out. It's so cute and the interior is a fucking dream. I love it. I'd move in here in a second. The only thing that I have is the bedroom, okay? Now, the bedroom is cute. It's freaking cute, okay? No arguing that. But it looks a little juvenile. Like, it kind of looks like a teenager room, which I'm not hating, but this is more like for a young adult, you know, with a pet, like a cat. I put some cat scratching posts in there. So, being that the bedroom looks a little bit more like a teenager's room, but it's still cute. I still like it. I mean, if you don't end up liking it, you can change the colors or you can exchange some of the furniture. But I think it still kind of fits the theme of the house. God, I am just now realizing how old actually this footage is because I started recording the speed build back before The Sims 4 had their big update where they reworked how foundations and pillars and like terrain in general was done. Like nowadays you can just drag it and you can even adjust the pillar sizes depending on like how high you have the walls. And this was taken, recorded way before, and I'm actually really enjoying the change, though I haven't actually built anything with it yet. But yeah, just in a second here, I'm gonna actually start working on the landscaping, which, oh, so cute. It's a dream. It's, you know, sometimes I can tend to go a little bit overboard with how I do it. But what I've recently started doing is I put in the terrain paint. And I kind of mark where I'm going to be putting the plants like that before, so I kind of have an idea. And I like that the ground, like the differently colored ground is kind of showing through the plants. So I'm putting that down first to have like a good idea of the placement, and especially in relation to proportions of trees and the house. So it's a good way to see if your plant placement is going to look nice in the grand scheme of things. Okay, Amy. Oh, and a tip, if you struggle with this like I have in the past, putting plants really close to the structure of the house is a freaking hassle when you have a foundation. So a little tip, I don't know if any of you know, I didn't know, I'm gonna tell you, it's gonna save your life. If you put the foundation down to ground level and then place your plants, you can put it as close to the house as you want. If you want, you can have the plants clipping through the walls on the interior. And then when you're done, you just drag the foundation back up to where you wanted it to be, and presto! Perfect plants across the house, and it looks really nice and clean and lined, and yes. It actually feels really fitting to come back to YouTube with a speed build in The Sims 4, because recently I have moved myself. Finally! Thank you, Jesus! God, if you knew how much I've been struggling to find my own place for so long, you'd lose your mind, okay? I've been looking for my own apartment for, oh my god, such a long time, and I finally found it, and it's been coming along. That's why it's been taking so much time, because, you know, it's always been my plan to start streaming and do YouTube on a regular schedule. But I haven't really been able to because I had roommates and I was moving back and forth and like the place was never ready. And I moved in my current place a couple of months ago and it's coming along. You know, I have furniture, the echo is finally gone, which is why I decided today is a good day to do a voiceover and get this freaking video out. And yeah, oh my god, if I am, like, I keep sitting, my desk is currently located in the living room out of, you know, I don't have an office here, but I keep looking to my living room, like turning around, and I can just, like, the couch is there. I recently got the couch, it was delivered last week, I think, and I put the decorations in place with a couch table, and I got this really cute rug, and oh, it fits my super, like, my pastel aesthetic, because everything is kind of, like, green, oh my god, no, it's gray, with gold brass highlights every here and then, like, the lamp and the curtain rail and a couple of details and the stuff that I've put on the couch table as decoration, and the main color is a really dusty kind of rosy pink, but more in a muted, almost purple lavender type of, like, okay, I'm not doing a good way of describing the colors, but it's so pretty. It's my dream home and it feels so cozy and nice, and it just feels like, you know, I've kind of finally come home after some really unfortunate, turbulent years of my life. I don't know, maybe I'll talk about it in the future if I feel a bit more confident actually showing parts of my life on YouTube. I'm kind of a private person, so doing this is really awkward, but I'm kind of doing it as a challenge to myself to just be more me and not be so scared to be me. I mean, in my day-to-day life, I'm not, if you ask any of my friends, I'm pretty out there, like, with my personality and everything. I don't really hide who I am at all whatsoever, but it's a bit intimidating on public places like the social media, YouTube and Twitch, and because you just never know what people will like, what people will accept, if your stupid, over-the-board personality is even gonna land and anyone is actually gonna even want to watch, and it's terrifying. But having my own place and kind of just being able to turtle and be on the inside and just get to know myself for the first time in my life really on my own without noise around me is such a nice feeling. It feels really good. So in the spirit of new beginnings and the new year, I have decided that it's about time for me to get back up on the horse. And I've been working tirelessly, well, it's a bit of an exaggeration, but I've been working really hard to completely overhaul everything. Even though I haven't started streaming yet, I've completely reworked everything for my stream, all of the visuals, the overlays, and the emotes. Oh god, my emotes are so cute if I'm ever actually gonna start streaming. And I get affiliate, you guys are gonna go nuts over my emotes. They're real cute. And I've worked for the upteenth time and redone my YouTube intro, and I'm just, like, I'm the more I'm learning about the direction that I want to take with the quality of my videos, the higher my standards are getting. And I've been kind of benched for a very long time because, you know, with the move and everything, as I've explained, it's hard when you're such a perfectionist to get comfortable with subpar quality, because that's not what I want to put out. I want to make amazing content and to the image that I have in mind for it, and it's really frustrating when I can't, because, you know, I want to do some sit down type of videos, I want to do some story times, but, you know, I just don't have 600 euros for a beginner video log camera. Why did I say it in such a weird way? Anyway, and it's really frustrating, but I have been sitting here on my butt for far too long, agonizing over how I'm gonna continue, and I've just You know, I, with my apartment coming together and my life kind of taking shape, my own personal life without anyone there to hold my hand taking shape, I've decided that it's time to stop procrastinating. It's time to stop being such a perfectionist and letting it stop me from doing what I want to be doing, and just start somewhere. So, I've reworked my intro and a little bit of my editing stuff, which you probably saw in this video. Not probably, I mean, unless you skip the intro, which I wouldn't blame you. And I really like the new vibe, like a little bit of editing, the lighting of the footage and everything, and I like it, I'm liking the vibe, but there's always areas to improve, which, you know, being a perfectionist is something that I strive for on the regular. And my videos will continue to improve because I can't stand having something go on for a very long time when I know how to make it better, you know? As in, if I know how to improve on something, I am not gonna be continuously using the old ways that I've done things if it's a subpar kind of quality and I've upgraded and I know how to make it better. So yeah. So I've been thinking about how I want to structure my future stream and my YouTube channel going to the future. And I'm a little bit stumped, to be honest, because originally I had this idea that I wanted to put out the type of videos that I made with my Hellblade: Senua's Sacrifice, you know, those analysis kind of videos that go into a deep dive of like really, like, you know, intense games, thriller type, psychology type, dark kind of games that explore the themes and the message that the game is trying to deliver to its consumer. And I love that. I'm definitely going to do more of that, but it's not feasible for me to do that on a regular basis because writing the script alone is a process that takes days, if not weeks, and then you have to record the footage, you have to get the clips in order, you have to edit the whole thing, make sure that the audio is right. And I don't have an editor, I'm doing everything myself, and me being a perfectionist kind of messes with me, and it's just not, I'm just not gonna be able to consistently do that on a weekly basis. So I figured, okay, so what can you do? And I have a list on my phone where I'm keeping my videos, like video ideas, and there are definitely a couple of like one-off videos that aren't necessarily series that I want to do, like Minecraft on hardcore mode and stuff like that, and a couple of videos with my boyfriend if he's ever gonna get his act together and actually sit down and do them with me. They're definitely coming at one point or another. I'm making no promises, I've learned my lesson from the past. But I'm definitely thinking about where I want to go and what kind of content I want to produce, because I'm also a consumer. Like, I watch a lot of YouTube. You'd be surprised. You'd be concerned, in fact, with the amount of YouTube videos that I watch on a daily basis. So being someone who has my own channel and is trying to create content, of course, I want it to be content that I would want to watch. So having that aspect to it is complicating things a little bit because I'm a little bit limited in what I can do. So I figured, considering how I love The Sims 4 so much, I could do maybe like a, I don't know, a Sims 4 Sunday where I don't make Sims content any other day except maybe when it's Sims 4 Sunday. Because Sims 4 is just such a great canvas to work with. Like, you can make story videos, machinimas, you can make let's plays, you can make challenges, you can make speed builds, and that's just a one game. And I love it for that. But as much as I love it, and as many, like, I watch so many Sims YouTubers, but it's just not exclusively what I want to be doing. I don't want to be in a relationship exclusively with a Sims 4, if you catch my drift. So I'm hoping the process of figuring out what kind of content I want to do and what kind of content I can do is not going to take too much longer. I'm working very hard to figure it out because I want to be consistent. I mean, I don't know how easy it's going to be to put that plan into motion because I'm struggling with depression a lot, and I always kind of have, so that oftentimes puts a really big kink into my plans when I'm trying to be productive, but we'll see. There's actually something else that I wanted to talk about. And it's window sills. Surprise, surprise. I was actually reminded of that because I was watching Freezer Bunny's, was it, Remodeling Newcrest? I think that's what it's called. His series where he's doing like a whole Japanese theme, and oh my god, these peoples are beautiful. I love Japanese architecture, and watching him build those beautiful, like, from traditional to modern houses, is just it's filling all the right spots, and it's great. But it reminded me that apparently windowsills aren't common at all, and I don't know about you, but I live in Germany, and windowsills are basic here. Like, every apartment, every house that you go to has a windowsill. Like, the depth of them varies, and more modern houses have smaller windowsills, but pretty much every house and every apartment has them. And I realized during the voiceover right now that, yeah, there are no windowsills in this build, which I've noticed that in American architecture, like, with the friends that I have, when they show me pictures of their houses, sometimes they ask me for advice on their interior decorating, and I noticed that they don't have windowsills. A lot of the times, anyway. Or if they do, they're very, very small, like, to the point where you can't even put any potted plants on them, which is unheard of in Germany. So, I was thinking, in the future when I'm building houses, you may as well just use some shelves. You know, just put some shelves under those windows. It's like, I realize a lot of the windows in The Sims 4 are really big. Like, they're frontal. Like, I don't know how to explain it. They're like bottom to ceiling. But in Germany, we have like medium height kind of windows where, because here the radiators are always below the window. So it's a little bit tricky to design a room, because you have to keep the radiators in mind. So you can't just like put a bed under the window, you can't put your couch under the window. I mean, you could, but you're basically cutting off the access of the radiator, and it's going to be really hard for the heat to actually fill the room if you do that. And I guess that's why our windows are more medium height. But I felt so stupid when I realized, wait, yeah, there are no windowsills. And I don't know why that detail got me the way that it did. But it's definitely something I'm going to be thinking about the next time that I build, whether it's private or in a video, I don't know yet, but I'm definitely going to start putting windowsills, like just regular shelves, whatever fits the frame of the window, just in the build, because it's, and just imagine, just put a plant in the windowsills, like how cute is that? It's something that I've never had in The Sims 4 because it never f***ing occurred to me until now, and I'm weirdly excited about the prospect of windowsills in The Sims 4. But honestly, I'm excited about anything that makes a build just that little bit more realistic and more, like, you can actually imagine living there. Something really weird happened when I tried to upload the build to the gallery, though. For some reason, it shows up marked as custom content, and I don't know why. I've tried to fix the issue in every possible way that came to my mind, and it doesn't make sense. In my library, it shows up normally. Is not marked as custom content, is there even if you don't check the box include custom content, it's just a regular Maxis Match build. But then as soon as I upload it from the library to the gallery, it gets marked as custom content. And I don't get it. I've tried really anything that I could think of. I've redone parts of the build and tried to re-upload it to the gallery, same issue. I went into the build and tried to look for any custom content items, nothing there. I used some Swatch importer, couldn't find anything. And then another weird thing happened when I tried to place it from the gallery on any lot. Parts of the build kept disappearing. Just like, and it's not like one or two items. No, it was a bunch of items that were just randomly gone. I had to completely redo the ivy on the outside of the house. Parts of the appliances were missing. Parts of the bathrooms were missing. Couch tables, plants. And it was so weird. It kept happening. Like, I restarted the game without CC active, and it kept happening. And I'm at the end of the rope. I don't know what to do. I'm really sorry. So if you want to download this build from my EA account, MiniTV, unfortunately, you're gonna have to make sure that you have the include custom content box ticked on the left side. Otherwise, it's not gonna show up on my profile. If any of you know how to fix that problem, please let me know. That way, at least I can make sure that in the future, if I want to upload a speed build, it's not gonna keep happening and you don't have to go through the trouble of activating or checking the include custom content box, because I keep forgetting. And if you're like me, you're probably also forgetting. But yeah, we're at the end of the build, and I hope you enjoyed this one. I sure did. I'm really proud of this one. By the time this video goes live, the build will be available on the gallery. Make sure to select EA accounts and type in a MiniTV. You should be able to find it. Don't forget that include custom content check button. I've included some screenshots at the end of the video, so if you want to see them, stay until the end. They're really cute. I tried to take really good angles, and yeah, hope you enjoyed them. If you like the build, give the video a like. If you want to see more, maybe subscribe, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye-bye! She's a Mona Lisa. Everyone's lining up to see her. There must be something about her features. You'll find her beauty goes much deeper once you get to meet her. You see her walking down the boulevard. She got the posture of a superstar. She looks so fly in those Gucci slides. Yeah, yeah, I wonder where she hides under her disguise. Yeah, 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 yeah. And all the girls around the world, they wanna be her. And all the dudes are trying to score like it's fever. She lives a double life, puts on a show. What's under this subtle smile, we'll never know. She's a Mona Lisa. Everyone's lining up to see her. There must be something about her features. You'll find her beauty goes much deeper once you get to meet her. She's a Mona Lisa. Everyone's lining up to see her. There must be something about her features. You'll find her beauty goes much deeper once you get to meet her. Let me paint a picture. I see they don't understand. Feeling like Picasso. She brushing against my hands. Seeing you from